satisfy any marketer. Artinya my time to talk to a group of digital marketer. You know, I realized something about this entire 2 days of conference. We have 4 speakers mentioning goldfish. If you remember, 4 times. And our hashtag on Twitter is amazing. You know why I say it's amazing? Because almost every single tweet has 0 engagement. We are at a digital marketing conference, right? But you know what the sad thing is that most of the time, we do not do what we learn, or we do not practice what we learn. So, to start off everyone, and I know that everybody is looking very, very lethargic. So I'm going to warm you guys up. We've been talking about engagement for 2 days, right? We've been talking about engagement for 2 days, right? So can we play an engagement game? Can I request every one of you who are busy at your computers answering email, chatting with your friends, can you just close the laptop for just the next 30 minutes, because I'm going to share something that really concerns you. Because now I'm not going to talk anything about campaigns, I'm not going to talk anything about strategy, I'm not going to talk about metrics, tools, blah, 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 and so on. I'm going to talk about the marketer, you, your personality. But first of all, to walk everybody up, I like to play a game with everyone, and I have my engagement cards here. Now, I'm going to give everyone one card. But before I give it out, I'd like to remind you, it's not very expensive. It's returning to me. Because even though I remind everyone to return me, I still lose a lot of cards. I only have 65%. So please, put it on a table. Do not take it home, so that I can collect it. So is it okay? So can I ask anyone in front here to help me distribute and give everybody one each? So maybe Nancy, right, you can help me. Right? And thank you very much. Right, so yeah, just give one some people there. Okay? Don't need to choose I have some more, please. Here. Okay, very, very quickly, everybody get one. Very quickly, everybody just get one. Okay, everybody got one card? Everybody got one card? Good. So, Vivian, can I request you to come out and do a demo with me on how to play this game called Quickie? Right? Oh, Tanti, so many cards left. Anyone do not have this card? Now, this is what we're going to do. Every one of you have this card, right? In a minute, I'm going to invite all of you to stand up. Nobody sit down. You have to go and find someone you have not talked to at all for the last 2 days. And you have to play this game. Okay, I'm going to demo to you. And once you are done with one person, you move on to another person. I'm going to give you 3 to 4 minutes to get to know as many people as possible. A lot of these questions are personal questions. Now, you have 2 ways to answer it. One is to tell the truth. Second way is to give a reason. Alright, so whatever it is, you are engaged. So we would like you to use this card, and a lot of this question that you see can be used on your social media campaign. Right? So everybody got one card? So can I invite Vivian? Oh, I'm going to just jump down and I'll put this demo here. By the way, I hope the name cards are still in the box, because at the end of my session, I'm going to draw 3 persons to walk away with my book. Right? So this is what we will do. You find someone you do not know, alright? And this is what you do, okay? Right? Right? Okay, so, okay, later. So this is what you do. You will read up, you will exchange cards. Whatever questions you get, you have to read up to the person, answer that question. So, for me, this is my question. What is one thing you fought the hardest for? It has to be that promotion during my army days. Yeah, because I asked my boss 3 times. So you are entitled to ask one question. Just in case you're not happy. But please, be concise. Less is more. Don't take the whole day, oh yeah, from sit down, you know, and that's all. No, we don't do that. Everybody will stand up and I just finished my answer. Now it's yours.
If you
grow
on the first
month,
one
bit
less,
much ramp
you have committed.
Oh, okay.
Bank robber.
Bank robber? Oh, that's not so bad. Just kidding. Alright, so after you're done, you keep my card. And I will go to another person and I will play the same game again. Alright? Okay? Hi, whatever it is. So everybody get the idea? Nobody sit down. If you sit down, I will sing you up later on for more demo. Okay? I don't like to see anybody sit down. Okay? So are you ready? Are you ready? Everyone, can I ask you to close your notebook? Push back your chair, stand up, and can I have some music? Alright? And let's go and find someone you talk to and change questions, and then you go on to the next one. Singapore doing matchmaking. Alright, I was the only man. So I had wonderful 4 years of meeting the most unique people on earth from 2005 to 2009. Now, I gave up that business because I can see that social media is emerging, the apps are emerging. One day, there will be no more business for me. True enough, today, everybody download Tinder. Who wants that Tinder? No one, right? Yeah. And I believe a lot of married people here, if I go to your phone, I will find Tinder on your phone. Alright? I'm not going to do that. So, 2009 to now, I'm doing a lot of speaking and training and so on. And I really want to share with you a lot of lessons I learned in life that can be applied to digital marketing. So, I want to play a very, very simple, let's skip all this. You can, of course, find me, and if you are quitting, please mention me. Right? These are 3 books. They are written. I have 1 latest one today. I'm going to draw for the 3 of you. So this is my big history. Let's go. Can I play a game with all of you? And this time is personal. This is time to use a mobile phone. I have here 9 images. I want to do a simple personality test. Now, are you alone will know the result? I'm not going to ask you, but if you want, you can, of course, acknowledge it. We have 3 columns. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1. This is how I will number it. I'd like you to look at these 9 images for a while. Look, choose one from every column this way. One from each column. One from each column. The image that you feel best resonates. That means when you look at this image, you find that image is you. This is your personality. So, 2, 3, 4 is one group, choose one. 5, 6, 7 is one group, choose one. 8, 9, 1 is one group, choose one. If you cannot remember, please use your mobile, zoom in and take a picture. Because I'm going to decode everything for you. So, please stay with me and do the test right now. Alright, I'll give you 30 seconds. Zoom in to the picture that best resonates with you. One column, one. Please choose carefully. I have a lot of revelations to show you today. The easiest way to learn today is every time when I unquote something, think of someone in your office that matches with this personality. And a good person to start with is your boss. Because if you don't know how to decode this personality, you will have a hard time. Have you ever seen social media managers who are completely anti-social in real life? I have met a lot in my life. Have you met people who are supposedly to collect data are so lack of focus to analyze them? Because they are better suited to go out there and do events. If you make them sit down and analyze data, they are in the wrong job. But just because they know how to do it, they are good at it, doesn't mean they will do a good job. Now, so, without doubling too much, are you ready? Have you chosen? Okay, if you don't choose, then you're not going to enjoy the rest of the talk. Alright, okay, so this is what I like to tell you. Every card has a name. So I don't know what card you have chosen. You have now 3 selections, right? 3 selections? Yes, ladies and gentlemen? Okay, good. Now, I want you to choose the one card that best resonate with you. Get out of this 3. But don't delete these 3 images. Pick one card that best resonates with you. Okay? Alright, let's go. Who chose this card? The man card in the graph. Anyone? I know you're going to tell me because you are a group of disengaged person. That's good. Whatever question I ask, you're not going to answer. So, you know, you tell me, okay? So I will not be asking. If you have this card, congratulations. You are the most systematic person we can find. To you, there's no such thing as organized mess. Your workstation is very neat. If I open up your wallet, your notes will be from the biggest to the smallest. Credit card from gold to silver to black, neatly arranged. When someone tries to sell you something new, you will say, that is not right, need to check the policy. To you, you are a very process-oriented person. You have a very good eye for details and mistakes, other people's mistakes. You are very good in processes. You have very high standard. To you, 99 is just pass. You are dedicated everything. That's why you enjoy doing OT, because you feel that without you, everything will collapse. You have to be the one doing the OT. Without you, everything will be better. But you're also reasonable. Now, here's the thing. If you don't let people know your personality and where you're coming from, others are going to find doing the OT. Without you, everything will be better. But you're also reasonable. Now, here's the thing. If you don't let people know your personality and where you're coming from, others are going to form perception about you. Do you agree? Do you agree that perception is stronger than the truth? It is. Because if the whole day I talk to you like this, and my nose are pointing out, after half an hour, what is the impression of me? Arrogant person, right? Right? You're talking over me. But today, I'm going to talk with you. I'm going to share with you that a person like this is very, very suitable to manage processes, to keep high standards. And there are people who love, who, there are some jobs that this person will love to do. Like what? Policeman. Compliance. Will you expect a happy-go-lucky person to be compliant? You will never. Lawyer, judges, accountant, auditor. These jobs require you to take a left or a right. Right? So, if you are doing digital marketing, you will be very concerned about the best practices. I want nothing but the best practices. And you're very concerned with methodology. What method are you using? So, want a person who is very process oriented, you're going to look at all these personality types and put them in the right place. But I want to tell you something. Every type is a challenge. Do you know what is that challenge? And now I don't care. I'm going to walk and I'm going to allow this shadow to follow me. The challenge is this. And sorry, cameraman, you have to move. But no speaker ever stand here, right? So I'm going to stand here. Not no, y'all will not get learned. Have you ever seen a happy-go-lucky perfectionist? You never. You know why? We have two primary emotions. One is anger. Two is sadness. He's angry with you for not meeting his standard. He's sad with himself for not meeting his own standard. That is why you will never see a happy-go-lucky perfectionist. But do you know what is the true definition of perfectionism? It is someone who imposes his standard on you. I am the standard. You don't pass my standard. You fail. In his mind as a score sheet, you are A plus, B minus, you are F. But he don't tell you. So in his mind, if you don't like a person like this, you will see you will say he's judgmental, alright? Inflexible and self-righteous. But there's no right or wrong type. We are all different. Now, granted, we are all unique, but there are certain standard groups of people. Right? So, let me invite this guy out of the door and want to talk about second one. Who has chosen this card? Okay, now, more honest, now we want to tell you, right? Okay, are you ready? Are you ready for the truth? Congratulations. You are the most people-focused of all personality types. You love people a lot. You are encouraging, you are humorous, you are very nurturing, you are a natural coach if you are a manager. Alright, you also very thick skin. You are a caregiver. You just love to be available. You have a need to be needed. You know what's the worst you can tell these people? I don't need you. just describe them. But because they are so attentive, sometimes they step over the boundary without them knowing. For example, let's go. If I am this type, I will ask you, maybe you don't look so good today. Is anything happening at home? You want a cup of tea? You want to go out and talk? Do you want my jacket? I'm intruding your space because maybe all you want is just leave me alone. I like to be alone. But because I want to be available so much, I overstep the boundary. But you know what's the biggest problem with a giver? We are guessing. We just don't know how to say no. We just don't know how to reject people. So you know what? In essence, this is the best people to borrow money from. Because the thing is that they can easily relate to people, really. And they are very caring, they are very warm, and they have a good sense of humor. Now, make a guess. What jobs will this person be best suitable for? Tell me, come to me, engage me. Nurses, right? You have to love people. Teachers. What else? Social worker. And customer service. But you have such a deep EQ. Do you know that a customer service professional, every day they get so much nonsense from the customer, and sometimes even verbal abuse over the phone, over email, over the counter, and the next day they can come to work and say, nothing has ever happened. That's why we have to learn these people. They are the Mother Teresa of our generation. The problem is, we've got to learn how to take care of ourselves. Right? So let me invite this person out. I'm going to invite third person in. Are you ready? Receive him. Oh, I want to tell you. If you're a marketer, you'll be very concerned about customer needs. You'll be very concerned about user experience, user interface. You'll also be excellent in drawing up the user persona. Because you understand people the best. So if you're a manager today, look for a person like this to spearhead your user persona creation. That is the best thing I can find. Third one, who chose this money maker? Okay, one there. Are you ready? You will be the most successful of all time. Why you will be successful? Because you will achieve your goal regardless of what happens. You know you like the limelight. You are competitive. You are flexible. You know how to be in the right place at the right time. You have two gifts. You know how to make small things look very big. That's marketing. You also know how to make big things look very small. That's crisis management. All right, yeah? It's very easy to spot them in office. A lot of certificates. A lot of pictures with member of parliament, all right, politician and so on. On their Facebook, everything is nice. When they ship house, they post. When they go to a new place, they will post. They know how to post. You will never find pictures like this in your Facebook because they're very, very concerned about their own image. To them, everything is about image. I want people to look at me as a person of success. Now, as I say, everyone has an issue. What is that issue? A failure. So go. Be optimistic. They are the best salesperson, best marketing person. They love the limelight. You know what else they like? Like KPI. Everybody hate KPI, but they love it. If you leave them out, they are very, very depressed. Why didn't you ask me to be MC? I love to be out there. Very competent. They respond to an email very fast. And they're able to motivate. They're able to even sell you a decision. So what is our problem? Your problem is they don't share anything emotional. Anything that makes them feel vulnerable, they don't share it. And they hate to and work that way. They're very concerned about how to do it. So if they are a marketer, they will be interested in all sorts of automation. Anything that makes things more efficient, they will go for it. So they are excellent in PR, in branding. Anything that gets the word out there, they love it. You need these people in the marketing team. They are natural. You don't have to teach them anything. They are born with this skill. They are born to enjoy their attention, and they know how to manage their attention. Who chose the crayon card? I know it's very rare. I'll tell you something about the crayon card. Are you ready? You are the most creative part of all. Why? You think and feel at a very deep level. To you, everything else is an aesthetic. You feel the world very differently from the rest. If people like you, they will say you are talented, intuitive. If they don't like you, they say you are weirdo. Because you just look at the world very differently. And they are the one that will give you the wow factor. Now, people who are born with this personality trait, they express their talent in the form of designer, producer, singer, dancer, sculptor, anything that allows them to translate their feelings into invention, they give you the wow factor. Have you ever seen the face of a designer when you reject their design? What's the color of the face? Black, right? Do you know what they're thinking? Let me tell you today. This is what they're thinking. You, what's wrong with you? This is my masterpiece. You don't appreciate it. I'm going to bring this to your competitor and see what he says. Because this person primarily thinking for himself. You know why they're so creative? They spend all their time with themselves. They love to be unique. They love to be treated special. If your event is black tie, they come with another neck. And they tell you, I'm special, why should I follow you? They hate to be ordinary. Have you ever seen an artist very happy when 10,000 people rush into the art gallery and watch an exhibition? They don't. They only want 100 people who can connect with them. And they like it when you don't understand their art. Because if everybody understands their art, they're all special. So they are unique. You just have to manage them. If you like to go for lunch alone, leave them alone. But they will say things you don't understand. It's okay. You're going to accept them. You know? So, they are very good with digital storytelling. That means you want them to create content, they are the best people. They are the best people to manage personal branding because they know how to stand out. So, now you know why some people are good at certain things. Now, big person comes. Has a child. Congratulations. You are the smartest of all. The most intellectual, the most knowledgeable, but also the most mysterious people around. Because you hardly talk. You like to absorb knowledge. You like to keep calm and be neutral. You are cool and collected in a crisis. Do you know that when a crisis struck in the office, these are the ones that is very cool? They say, let's sit down and analyze whatever. Get too emotional. And what is ASAP, everyone? What is ASAP? As what? To our observer, ASAP means as slow as possible. Don't rush me because ASAP is a word I hate. Because they need time and space to process everything. That is why in a meeting for 2 hours, they don't talk at all. But when you ask them, what do you think after the meeting? And they can tell you one liner that is urgent. Wow, how did you observe that? Because they are very perceptive. They think well by the side. That's why they can absorb all the wisdom, all the knowledge. And do you know what's the most frustrating thing about them? It's the way how they answer your question. What do you think? Oh, it depends on what you want. In what A do you think this? In what B? You know, I was a child actor before, so I can act out all the personality. I have been equally convincing. Think about that. They possess take knowledge a lot. They don't take part in any action. They rather observe. So they technically are poorest decision maker in the world because they just observe, analyze, and don't do much. They need someone to kick their butt, and I'll tell you who later. We all need someone. We all need someone. So there are famous people that we know who are like that. Wanna know who? Bill Gates. Steve Jobs is the last one, the creative one. He creates something before you even think that you need it. He's a creator, right? Bill Clinton, it's a country performer. Mother Teresa is a country. And people like Gandhi is like one. So if an observer is doing digital marketing, you know what he would like to do? He would like to do research, analytics, and he will do prediction. Because anyone who learns to study analytics will like to project into the future. And this is the best people to ask because he can do everything without much emotions. Purely data. Purely data. Alright? So who chose this teamwork card? I believe the most. Oh, nobody. One day. Teamwork card. If you choose this card quietly and not tell me, I can understand. Because you're not even sure whether you're like that. Let me tell you this. This person is the most complicated of all. Because on the one hand, they're very engaging. They're very trusting. You say jump, they will say how high. You say go and run, they will say how far. They are very good follower. They don't like surprises. They can stay in a company for 10 years because they just enjoy routine. They are the worst people to have free and easy travel with. You know why? Because to them, play by the ear, see how it goes, are not in the dictionary. They like to know what is going on. You better tell me exactly what I need to do. And they always play devil's advocate. They like to ask one question that has no answer. What if tomorrow they come out? What if I go home late now? What if this thing doesn't go out? And you know what's the most fascinating about them? Is that when they raise a concern, they are actually usually right. But they always tell you last minute. The day they're supposed to launch tomorrow or something tonight, they call up everybody, guys. Then the leader will ask them, how did you know? Why didn't you say so earlier? Well, I don't know whether when it's a good time to tell you. But I think I'm so worried. I better tell you now. And you know what? That's why it's so complicated. They have high anxiety. They get very worried. They're the only one worried. When you think everyone worried like them, they feel very good. They feel safe that now I belong to the majority. So this is a zebra looking. Do you think a zebra looks for a lion, ladies and gentlemen? But this zebra looks for a lion. Because if the lion doesn't appear anywhere, the danger can be from anywhere. But if the lion appears here, okay, I run there, safer. That is why they are very complicated. In my days as a dating agency owner, this is the personality that I have most people with. They have a tendency to remain single for a long, long, long time. But they are very worried about having the wrong person. Because to them, life is a jungle. You know why? They have very little chance. That's why, if they're doing digital marketing, they will be very concerned about checklists. They will be very concerned about privacy issues. They will be very concerned about teamwork, getting a team together. But you need these people in your team. This is the one they will watch on that, because having someone to ask what if is absolutely essential for you. No plan is foolproof. You but to ask this person, can you see anything wrong? And you know what he is by? He has 1,000 enemies. Who has this adventure part? I'm coming to the end. Wow, so many. You are the most fun, spontaneous, and adventurous of all. You are very versatile. You are visionary, you can see the big picture very easily, and it's why you should be a starter. you should be a founder or a startup. Because you can see the big picture, you are fun, you like options all the time. You just have a few problems. One of them is this, you have short attention span. Shorter than both, you should get out 5 times. You have short attention span. If you like something, you should quit immediately because after a while, you will be very bored. Nothing holds your attention for too long. These people are meant to run around. These people are meant to do short-term stuff. You ask them to plan a D&D, very good. You ask them to do a change management, they will never repeat. They know how to make tough work fun. That is why they are the ones that inject the most fun. And fun is what is lacking in marketing. Because fun can be dangerous. But to this person, he's a risk taker. You know what's the favorite for the word? Not starting to end. For a person like this, the volatile word is next. This doesn't work. Next. It's okay. They don't like to dwell in sadness for too long. They're always happy. But because they are always happy, they have one major issue in life. You know what is that? They never learn the lesson. Because it's always next. They don't ponder. So, when it comes to digital marketing, they like to multitask. They like to do events, they like anything short-term. Advertising, campaigns, alright, anything short-term, they love it. Anything long-term, like content, marketing, this is not the right person. So, and they like to engage with digital influencers. So, Seven is a very fun person. I have this part as well. Okay? I'm not going to tell you what part I am. If you're interested, connect with me on LinkedIn, and I give you an ebook. Alright, and I share with you more info about this. Okay, last one. Who has this strong man's card? Strong man, please don't be shy. Congratulations! You are Donald Trump in disguise. You are direct, confident, straightforward, cut the chase, no sugarcoating. You say it as it is, you take initiative. You just don't care what the world thinks of you. You are a natural bulldozer. You are excellent when you need to be the forerunner to start something new. You are always right there. It's suitable for you. If people like you, you are the inspirational leader. If they don't like you, you are absolute yip. Right. You are also very controlling, technically. Oh, let me go backwards actually. Just now the adventurer. Technically, they are the worst people to marry. Because they like options all the time. Okay, so this person is hard on everybody else but soft to his own people. They are like a marshmallow wrapped around my top body. Really, look at our late founding Prime Minister, Lee Kuan Yew. He can be tough to everyone, but the minute when the press interviewed him about his wife, he becomes a little boy. Because whenever he talks about something he loves, he becomes his soft self. So, everyone has a weakness. Are you ready for this? This is exactly like a child. And if a person like this, most of the time, this person becomes your CEO, your MD, your chairman. They are the leader. They say, go, you have to go. And this is the one that don't care about what you think of him. And they will tell you, if you reject him, he will say, if you don't like him, you can go out, or you can be out of IT. That's the matter. I will still go on. So this is a very tough person to work with, but it's extremely essential in crisis situation. Last one. So they are good in almost everything, to be honest. Okay? Last one. Who has this very same card? I love you the most. Because you are the nicest person on earth. You don't have much of a temper. You are patient with people. You are peace loving. You are a natural facilitator. You love. You are very forgiving and you are very gentle. You are so nice. until people cannot think of anything special about you. That's the irony. You know, during my dating agency days, a lot of ladies come to me, Andrew, please find me a nice guy. So I found them a nice guy. And the ladies almost every time they would complain, Andrew, those guys are boring. Okay, I give them the adventurous person. Wow, exciting. After a while, no sense of security. What happened? Right? So what I'm going to tell you is this. This person, although he's very peace-loving, he's an excellent negotiator. But every one of us need to be like him. Because he thinks the larger aspect of the world. Because he sees everything you don't see. He may be very oblivious to the surrounding because he's very concerned about what everybody is feeling. He's a very inclusive person. You sell him a new idea, the first thing that he will say is, I want to hear what the rest say. What's his favorite word? Let's discuss. Let's have another discussion. Okay? Let's discuss some more. Let's have a round table. Let's have a focus group. That is why negotiation takes so long. But he's the best person to negotiate. So, at the end of the day, these are the attributes of a person. Inclusive, non-judgmental, good, engaged. And if you are doing digital marketing, you'll be very, very good with metrics. You'll be very, very good as a community manager. You'll be very good to facilitate personal focus discussion. So, ladies and gentlemen, what am I saying at the end of the day? Do you know why I wish to cut this way? Now I'll tell you one more thing that will blow your mind. The left column is a reflection of your feeling. Whatever path you have chosen, that is how you feel. The middle column is about your thought process. And the right one is about how you manage your action. So, we are all making up of our mind, our will, our emotions. Our personality is actually our soul. So, this tree is a combination of your complete self. But there is one part that's very, very dominant. That is the part that everyone must see or can see. So what is my message to all of you? I'm going to skip this and you can get that. I have, if you'd like to research more on this, this is inspired by anagram. This is pronounced as anagram. Anas means nine, gram means type. Not anagram, it's anagram. I have three messages for you and this is my closing. Your personality determines how you see the world. If you see the world as black and white, everything you do will be black and white. You'll be very unforgiving in many situations. You need to find a person who is more spontaneous. Every type has a complementary type. I don't have time to share. If you want to know, you can send me a message and I will reply to you. How you see the world is important. Because your world and my world are all different. But when our world collapse, when our world collides, who needs to give? Who needs to give? Depending on who is the client and who is the vendor. Depending on who is the boss and who is the staff, right? Number two, our personality determines how we react to different situations. Some people will never have a plan B because they think that their plan is foolproof. How you react to different situation reveals your true colors. You will never know me, I will never know you until we have a crisis together. Then we will test the strength of our relationship. You will never know how close you are with your client until your client and you have a crisis together. Then you will know your true colors are out. That is why most jobs OJT are 6 months. Do you know why? Because after 6 months, your true colors will surface. You can't pretend for 6 months. 6 months is the maximum. Third one, I want to leave with you. Your personality type determines how you adjust to the environment. Sometimes you hear people saying this. You know, 5 years ago, I wasn't like this. But after working for this company, I become like this. You have been adjusted to the environment. It's time to discover the true you. Because if you do not know the real you, you'll become a corporate zombie, just doing digital marketing day in, day out. Do you know what are corporate zombies? They are people who have mentally resigned, emotionally divorced from my company, and they are loaning their body to the company. And because they loan their body to the company, they charge the company a rental called salary. So they are not motivated by money. To them, it's renting their body to you. Now, don't be a walking zombie. I've seen many marketers who have no passion in their work. They are a marketer by job, but they are not a marketer. I'll give you an example. When I first saw the pitch box, I took a picture and I sent it to my client. My client is the biggest microphone manufacturer in the world. And I sent it to the marketing department. Hey guys, look, people are creating, are innovating this kind, they're delivering a new experience. I think you should look at it. And they replied, oh, thank you very much for letting us know. Because it is my passion to be committed to my client's success. I leave my brand every day. When I see this, first thing I know is, can my client benefit from this? But since I'm the one who see it, and I send this info to someone, can I add value to someone? You gotta have an attitude every day. If not, work is just work. Whatever strategy you have to also love people. Your personal branding is very important. A lot of us can market a lot of things, but we are just very bad at marketing ourselves. If I look at your LinkedIn profile, I know. I go to a lot of people's LinkedIn profile. They are a marketer, but I don't see much of the marketing in their profile. So today, I really hope that you and I, we can connect on LinkedIn, we can learn something on how to market each other. Because if you don't market yourself, you are missing out on the biggest investment. Personal branding. It's very important for your future success. One last thing I want to share. If you don't manage your personal branding, someone else will do it for you. That someone else is called perception. Let perception be your truth today. With that, thank you very much.